Hello friends, here is the fourth part of the series of videos on finding the speeds of trains. Problems related to trains are very common in competitive exams, and you need to be thorough with the methods which are used to solve all kinds of problems related to trains. So here I'm taking two more examples, all previous year questions which have occurred in one or the other competitive exam, and you need to be well acquainted with the methods which I'm going to discuss here. The first question is, there's a train which is 240 meter long and it is traveling at the speed of 600 km per hour. And there's a man who is running in opposite direction. That means if the train is going like this, a man is running like this at 6 km per hour speed, and we need to find the time taken by the train to cross the man. So let's see how this problem can be solved easily. In this case, the speed, first of all, you need to understand that whenever the train is going like this and relative motion of the man or the train is in opposite direction, then the speed gets added. So the speed which we'll be using in the question is actually the sum of the two speeds, 60 plus 6, that is 66 km per hour, which needs to be converted into meter per second by multiplication with 5 by 18. So this will be, okay, this goes 3 times, this goes 11 times. So this is 11 into 5, which is, okay, 6 3 is 18 and 6 11s are 66. So 66 into 11 into 5 is 55, and by 3 meter per second. So this is the speed which we have to consider in this case. Now, for finding the time taken to cross the man, we need to use the formula distance upon speed. So the distance is the length of the train, which is 240, and speed is to be taken, the speed which is to be taken is the relative speed of the train with respect to the man, that is 55 by 3 meter per second. So we need to divide this by 55 by 3. So this will become 240 into 3 by 55. Now we can cancel this by 5. This will be 11 and this will be 4, 8. So this is 48 into 3, 144 by 11. This is approximately, okay, I'll use a mixed fraction for this, 144 by 11. So if you divide 144 by 11, you will have 13 as the quotient and 1 as the remainder, so 1 by 11. So 13, 1 by 11 seconds is the time taken for crossing the man. Now let's see the next question, in which there is a train 240 meter long, again the length is the same, and it crosses a bridge in 80 seconds and a standing boy in 40 seconds. So there are two times which are given in this question, that of crossing a bridge and that of crossing a stationary buoy, and we need to find the length of the bridge. Now in this case, the speed is obviously distance by time, and the distance is the length of the train, that is 240, and the time taken to cross the buoy, because length of the bridge we have to find out. So first we will be using the data relating to the buoy. So time is 40 seconds to cross the buoy, so this is 6 meter per second. So this is the speed of the train. Now again, if you see, speed is equal to distance by time in case of the bridge, then speed we have already found out as 6. Now the distance is the length of the train plus the length of the bridge. So I consider that the bridge is x meters long, so total distance to be covered is 240 plus x, divide by time, and the time to cross the bridge is 80 seconds, so divide by 80. Now this is a simple equation in one variable which is to be solved. So this is 480 minus 240 equal to x, thereby giving you the length of bridge as 240 meters. So friends, these are the questions you need to be well acquainted with in order to succeed in any kind of competition. And I hope you have watched all the four parts of the series of videos on these train problems, and you will be greatly benefited by these videos. So if you like all these videos, do share it with your friends and do not forget to subscribe to the channel.